Epstein's anomaly is one of the cyanotic congenital heart diseases in which natural survival to adulthood is not uncommon. Echo picture demonstrates the gross distal displacement of the septal tricuspid leaflet and the atrialized portion of right ventricle marked as ARV. A portion of the right ventricle is atrialized due to distal displacement of the septal and posterior leaflets of the tricuspid valve. The anterior tricuspid leaflet is large and sail-like. It produces a loud tricuspid component of first heart sound while closing, which is called the sail sound. Please subscribe to this channel for future updates. Click on the subscribe button. Press the bell icon after that for all updates. About half of the patients with Epstein's anomaly can have atrial septal defect or patent foramen ovale. In Epstein's anomaly, the right-to-left shunting is not due to pulmonary hypertension, but because the tricuspid regurgitation jet is directed across the atrial septal defect. Almost half of the patients with Epstein's anomaly have evidence of a right-sided axillary pathway with a WPW syndrome. This can be associated with atrioventricular reentrant tachycardias as well. Right atrial overload with tall Himalayan P waves and polyphasic or splintered QRS complexes are the other ECG hallmarks of Epstein's anomaly. The age of presentation in Epstein's anomaly may vary from childhood to adulthood depending on factors like the severity of tricuspid regurgitation, associated abnormalities like atrial septal defect, and the pulmonary vascular resistance in the newborn. Auscultatory hallmarks of Epstein's anomaly are multiple heart sounds, loud T1 or sail sound, and a scratchy superficial diastolic murmur due to tricuspid stenosis. In the adult, a striking feature is often the huge enlargement of the cardiac silhouette, contributed mainly by the large right atrium and the atrialized portion of the right ventricle. This X-ray from a person with Epstein's anomaly shows cardiomegaly, which is not so huge, and right atrial enlargement. Cardiomegaly with relative oligemia of the lung fields and reduced cardiac motion can produce a stenciled out appearance in Epstein's anomaly. The large right atrium and an association of right-sided axillary pathways make Epstein's anomaly prone for supraventricular tachycardias. Localization and ablation of axillary pathways in Epstein's anomaly is difficult due to the large right atrium and distorted anatomy. The atrialized portion of right ventricle will show ventricular electrograms and an atrial pressure tracing. This is known as Hernandez sign. Hernandez sign is elicited using a catheter which can record electrogram as well as measure the pressure, known as Sucker catheter. Epstein's type of anomaly of the left atrioventricular wall is seen in levotransposition of great arteries, known also as congenitally corrected transposition, LTGA and CTGA. Epstein's anomaly has been associated with maternal intake of lithium during pregnancy. M-mode echo in Epstein's anomaly shows the delay between the mitral and tricuspid valve closures. Both valves are imaged in the same parasternal view in Epstein's anomaly. The distal displacement of the septal tricuspid leaflet is the characteristic echocardiographic finding in Epstein's anomaly, noted in apical four-chamber view. Surgical repair is by Da Silva's cone procedure, which constructs a funnel-like valve using the native valve leaflets. This avoids the problems associated with artificial valves, including bioprosthetic valves, especially in children. Here are a few journal references on Epstein's anomaly. Please don't forget to subscribe to this channel for future updates and click on the bell icon for all updates. Thank you.